morning students, how are you all? I hope all is well. In our class yesterday we learned the different parts of a flower. So let's recall them. So what are the parts of a flower? Stalk. Then green leaf like structure is called sepal. Then colored prominent part of a flower is known as petal. Okay, name the male reproductive part of a flower. Very good, stamens. Then name the female reproductive part of a flower. Yes, pistil. So these are the different parts of a flower. So today we will discuss the different functions of a flower. So mainly the flowers produce a sweet smelling liquid that is known as nectar. So insects attract nectar. So insects attract nectar. Give example for insect. So bee is an example for insect. So when an insect land on the flower to feed, the pollen grains. Do you heard the term pollen grains? Pollen grains are powdered and also yellowish in color. So these powdered and yellowish male cells present on the stamen. So powdered yellowish colored male cells present on the stamen, that is known as pollen grains. So when an insect land on the flower to feed, these pollen grains that will stick on the bodies of insect. So when insect travel from one flower to another, so with these traveling they can also carry the pollen grains. So transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another, this is known as pollination. So transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another is known as pollination. Then the second function of a flower is it helps for reproduction. Do you heard the term reproduction? Reproduction is a process of giving birth to their young ones. So reproduction is a process of giving birth to their young ones. So here the stamens, the male reproductive organ stamens, produce male gametes. Gametes means reproductive cells. So here the stamens produce male gametes, and the pistil produce female gametes. Pistil produce female gametes. So here the male gametes fuses with the female gametes to form zygote. So this is the process of reproduction. So male gamete fuses with the female gamete to form zygote. So this is the reproduction. So flowers helps for reproduction. Then the third function is it in some plants the flowers store extra food. Example, broccoli and cauliflower. So the first function of a flower is to flowers provide nectar to certain birds and insects. Then pollination means transfer of pollen grains from one flower to another. Then second function is flowers helps in reproduction. That means help in the union of male and female gametes. Then third function, some plants store extra food in the flowers. Example, cauliflower and broccoli. So these are the three main functions of a flower. Is it clear? Thank you.